Are you ready?
This array is called PPE, which is personal protective equipment. Everything in it is from traffic vests to masks for respiratory protection.
Right.
I think it's masks, all sorts of things. Yeah. Over here we have a little bit more. These are high risk kits. And then we have shrouds for dead bodies. We have obstetrical kits, which is for delivering babies. This is pretty much everything that you need to deliver a baby.
You guys go through training for that?
Yeah. Well, we pretty much our EMT training covers all of this stuff. This is airway management. With airway management, you have bag valve masks for rescue breathing. When someone cannot breathe on their own, you do this for them. You squeeze, breathe for them. These, you know, so you put these for oral adjuncts, and you put them in the mouth, and you open up. Basically, you take the tongue,
clear the passage, right?
Clear the passageway. This is if you can't get in there for the knot, for the nose, you spill it into the nose, and it sits there. Masks, any various degrees of sizes and methods of delivering oxygen. Nebulizer kits are over there for people with asthma. Sterile water and saline. Sodium chloride is for heavier wounds. This is for wound irrigation.
Do you know who that person is? Yeah.
Over here are suction parts. Whenever those things block in the airway.
Rancio, right? That's his
yes.
Rancio.
I think bombs, Bill.
ARN.
This is your trauma management.
Your best bet is to give Bill's information.
Yeah. This is trauma management, wound care. Triangular bandages are the ones that like a bandana. Various sizes of roller gauze. Over four. Ice packs.
718.
Burn sheets. They're basically like a huge blanket.
979.
Which is used for
5850.
For people who have, you know, systematic burns. Trauma. Dressing. It's a big one about big for larger wounds.
From a yellow
2x2s and iPads. These are for your eye, obviously.
Is this all inventory?
Yeah, this is all inventory.
Thank you for inviting me.
5x9s, it's just slightly larger ones, and just varying other degrees, sizes. Basically, just varying degrees, sizes of bandages and trauma management. Mm. Tape or, you know. All the stuff we carry in these bags, too. These are called our jump bags.
So you go take it with you.
Yeah, whenever we want to call, we take any varying them out. The bags we have are suction, portable suction. This is, you know, carry this with us for, like, cardiac arrest. AED defibrillator. Which is this. The defibrillator, which also carries our medications in it. We have aspirin, albuterol, glucose, epinephrine. We are going to be carrying naloxone, which is anti-opiate overdose medication.
You need that on Staten Island.
Yeah,
that's why we're getting it.
Opiate Island.
Opiate Island.
And then that is our portable O2.
Oxygen. That's also carrying our diagnostic equipment, extra stethoscope.
You
and
change the bag on that too?
Blood pressure. Cuffs.
This is
for BBP, which is blood
passage.
Bloodborne pathogens, which is cleaning equipment. This is very powerful germicide.
Just put this in with
Windex.
The AED for now.
These are actually the pads that you put on, or the defibrillator. Mm. You put them on the chest when your person's in cardiac arrest. When the heart doesn't work anymore.
Claire.
Yeah, we call this the toaster. Carrying disposal kits. For, this is called a Sharps container.
Hazmat stuff?
Yeah, in a way, yeah. This is for when we have like maybe bloody bandages, you're gonna get rid of, you throw them in here. Sharps containers is usually carried by paramedics. Thank you. Usually carried by paramedics because they have IVs and sharp stuff, so the Sharps containers are sharp stuff.
Stretcher's coming in.
Step
it off. No, you're good.
You're good. Yeah. No,
you
can
go on that side.
Okay.
You can go on that side.
Okay. Just lift up the rail. It's intense. They're getting recorded. Yeah, really. It's actually a good thing. Yeah, this is a little messy. Put the stretcher in. We never get to take this on board. It's not good.
This compartment over here is linen for this spare linen, and then we have like bedpans and stuff like that.
Porta potty.
Yeah. Basically, over here we have the onboard suction and onboard oxygen. For suction and oxygen, we have onboard and portable. Portable and onboard. So I mean, portable and suction and oxygen's over here, and the onboard's over here.
Total of 8 bottles on board.
Yeah. We are called a LSU, Logistics Service Unit for Oxygen. Mm. Right behind you, over here,
these are called escape hoods. Well, escape kits, I should say.
This is your post-9/11 world right here. After 9/11, they were given this stuff. These are basically gas masks.
That was a problem for a lot of emergency responders. They couldn't breathe.
Yep. So this is, I mean, I don't think any emergency services have ever had to use this in the United States that I know of. But it contains
the PBE.
Yep. Contains an escape hood, which is a gas mask, and a high risk kit, gloves, gown, all sorts of stuff. I think there's like a book in here too, for like some general information. I can find how to open this.
So do you got who takes care of inventory and checking dates, make sure it's in? Complete?
Well, we have the logistics officer. Yeah. Who's this gentleman right here?
Is that done every time you go?
Done every I do it at least 3 times a week.
3 times a week.
Yeah.
Make sure you have
to. But whenever the crew goes out, they have to check it.
They have like a.
There's a sheet called a Parts 800 sheet.
Yeah. I figured. Yeah, this is some kind of checklist. To have to go through.
We have to fill this out every single time we go out.
Right.
So we carry couple of these on the ambulance. After these expire, the state's not giving us any more.
Oh, I get one.
It's a big one. So, alright, I believe that's it for the inside, so let's go to the outside. Alright. This is your MCI bag. MCI is Major Casualty Incident. These are called trauma tags. Yeah. This is for trauma for triage tags. What you do is, I'm actually going to use one. Oh, now you pull it up. Good for triage tags. If you have, let's say, 15 people injured and you're alone, what you need to do is, you need to categorize their wounds, which is about here. So what you do is you would peel off one. Like say they're a yellow tag, which means you can move slow, but you have to move with them. And one of these, I believe, is either triaged and then ambulance. I mean, you have to bring by ambulance. So like say you're going to transport this person. What you do is you will draw out where the wounds are. Say they got shot in the stomach, you'll put like a circle there, GSW. You put the time and the blood pressure, the pulse, and the respirations, and you would do at least 3 of these. And then if they did an IV, which we don't do, you put pretty much your general information. And then you would put your, and then you would take it and you would tie it around the arm, the toe, depending on the tag. Say the person, green means they're okay. Means they're not okay, but they're walking wounded, meaning you don't have to really worry about them. If you have enough, you can just leave them where they're. Yellow means you have to deal with them, but you can take your time with them. Red means critical, meaning they're in critical condition. Like say they're on death's door. Black means once you go black, you never go back. So
that's it, huh? That's, yeah. You don't want to get that card.
What you do is, this is called your black tag.
Yeah.
When you have a black tag, it means done. What you do is check for pulse, then you check for respirations. If they have no respirations, tilt their head up, listen again, nothing, black tag them.
Is that standard amongst all
MCIs?
Yeah.
See, if we get on scene and we have someone who would otherwise be, like say, we're like down the block and it's just a normal day and we're out and about, we get someone who would otherwise in an MCI scenario be called a black tag, we would work on them. But a black tag is basically, if you have so many people, it becomes unmanageable. You're not going to worry about the dead. So it's a management system. It's grim work.
Well, but, it's realistic. You know, you got to deal with
what really you got. Anyone ever have to use these? I doubt these have been ever used. They have spare straps. Stretcher. Fix it as I go along, please. There we go. This is your spare oxygen. With your spare oxygen, pretty much whenever you need to replace them, pull it out, open it up.
Is that in addition to the five? Or?
Yeah. We have two in there, and one in the bag, and then you have four extra here. Usually keep like large scene, like just general. This is kind of empty, but we can't keep a bag of turnout gear, which is I'm sure you've seen. You know what the firefighters wear, stuff like that. We have a lighter version called bunker gear, helmets, all sorts of fun stuff. These are your different boards and extrication devices and all that stuff. This is your short board. This is a short board. This is a CPR board. You can put this under a person, like if they're on a bed or something. You can do CPR on them. Scoop stretcher. You'll unhook it and you can slide it under the people in person like that. And your general long board, your spine board. That's just pretty much that's the one you'll use. Say if someone fell like 10 feet like down, you'll package them up. Consider the full body immobilization. Speaking of immobilization, it's one of three. You have three sizes of splints. Each one for varying. If the person's tall, you put it on the outside. If the person's shorter for the legs. This is like that. You want to mobilize, say they broke, have like a compound fracture right here. Mm-hmm. This is where the bone's protruding. You'll wrap it up and then you'll feel like a sling slot. That's it. You'll hold it like this and it doesn't happen. This is called a traction splint. If someone has a femur broken, which is your largest bone in your body, it also produces marrow. If it's broken, what this does is it pretty much will, if it has a, like if the bone went like that, what it does is it just slides it out because it's traction. It'll actually extend. And you also have your head, which is Hendrix extension. It's basically like a vest that you put on. If someone's CD is like a car accident, it up and then you strap them up from the board on the strap. Bench has two components on it, actually. You have your seatbelts like this, but you also have your seatbelts that go down like that. What you can do is, you can actually put a longboard on here, and you can transport two patients and mobilize them. And this, see how. Another thing is, with the spare stretcher, if you fold it out, these little knobs here, these notches, actually hold the wheels and hold like the pegs for it.
That's why
so
I want
keep
that hold
the spare stretcher right here.
And you, instead of putting it in
you
my
can
pants.
Transport one seated patient, one patient on the stretcher, And then if you have a spare stretcher or a longboard, you can transport up to 3 patients. That's pretty much it.
Cool.
I wouldn't transport any more patients.
Good job. Thank you.
That's it.
Very good.
Thank you.